Good morning, fans of Privateer FX. Coming at you at the European Open today. We got a little bit of vol there yesterday at the end of the day. Let's see what happened. Mainly cable collapsed down to the 200 hour zone here. 140.67. We kind of got what we want here. As we talked about, this range top here, we're looking for three red days. We got those now. I don't really see whether this is going to go another red day or not, so we're going to stay away from cable now. We've kind of cleaned up our small shorts. What else happened? Finally, Aussie broke 77.40. Can you believe it? So classic. Started the day, spent all of Europe between 95 and 05. Slowly the boat turned. And then we did get acceleration through 44. Never traded back above 44. 13.14 now. We got given it 10 overnight, so we're out of that. We're playing it on the short side now. This is bearish engulfing. But it's bearish engulfing kind of in the middle of the range, so it's not quite as powerful as other bearish engulfings. So this is a short, but it's between 35 and 55 today, if we get up there. The main event today will be dollar CAD, which finally closed above the 200 day. So this is quite interesting and important. We got CPI and retail sales today in dollar CAD, so we want to try and be creative and look at ways to be long or short CAD. Obviously that's 7 hours away, so we're not going to go crazy now, but you want to be looking at Euro CAD, CAD Yen, dollar CAD as we get closer to this number, see if there are any setups that we like. The bias is going to be to sell CAD just because Pollutz and the BOC were a little bit more dovish than we had expected. So they obviously have a little bit more forward guidance on some of these numbers, I think. But that said, you got to look both ways and check us out at the New York Open, or today, I guess we should call it the Toronto Open. To see where dollar CAD's gonna go. Let's take a look at Euro Yen. We were looking at this yesterday. Ended up being sort of a nothing day. We do like selling Euro Yen. Trying to get short this stuff heading into ECB next week. I think they're gonna be more dovish than people expect. One of the things we're watching closely is when Euro Swiss is going to turn, which may seem odd, but I feel like Euro Swiss is going to be sort of the harbinger for Euro and Euro crosses to go lower or higher. As you can see right now, we're 120.05. We've printed, this will be the 8th green day in a row. If it's green, I'm getting very cautious with Euro Swiss. My instincts, my intuition tells me we're going to trade up to sort of 120.20 just to shake out a few stops here above the figure, but hard to be long Euro Swiss here after 8 green days above the magical 120 line in the sand. You should all take a moment to reflect where you were that day. It's kind of one of those FX days. We all remember where we were and what we were doing. What else is there? Oh yeah, DollarMex. DollarMex had a thumper yesterday. And we like this to continue higher. Tidy little finish to the move at 1850, really 1849. And change, but we'll call it 1850. 200 day right there as well. like this to continue higher. Why this happened? There's a myriad of reasons, but looks like oil's turned. Let's pull up that oil chart. So I got that long leg on the top side there, heading into 70 bucks. Big turn midday, and now we're looking for a new daily low just to kind of confirm change in trend. So yesterday's low was 67.98, so we'll call it 68 to figure. We're 68.12 now. I wouldn't be long oil. You know, I have a natural bias to be short oil, but I don't see any reasons to be long oil. Even if Saudi Arabia wants oil at 80 bucks for the Aramco IPO, I think they have much less control over the oil market than people think. But anyway, I have no evidence of that. That's just my personal bias. So keep that in mind. Anyway, for the European session today, we're going to be tentatively selling Aussie Yen. We're going to be tentatively selling Aussie. We may try and sell some CAD Yen as well. And then the New York session, where the meat of the day normally is, we'll be looking closely at Dollar Mex and Dollar CAD. Good luck out there, guys. Talk to you later.